Greetings, Monday Clubbers. Tony here. Hope you're all well and coping with what is worsening news on the COVID front. That's not good. But for me, it's my birthday tomorrow, and my birthday always corresponds with the first day of the year, which is longer than the previous day. So the days are getting longer from tomorrow. The earth is tilting towards the sun. So that's not bad, is it? And more good news. This YouTube is being upgraded from YouTube to Zoom. Now you've heard of Zoom, you've seen it a lot on TV. It's perfect for this because we can all familiar faces are on it. We can all paint together with chat and laughs. It's lovely. I've sent emails out and you'll get more from the U3A website and letters they'll be sending out. So it's easy to do. You just click on a link to get Zoom on your computer and click on the link that's on the email and you're in. And it's great. So I hope you do it. I'd like to see everybody again. So a little painting coming up. This. So I'll be painting this shortly. And of course you can paint it. So let's do that and have a good Christmas as much as you possibly can. And hopefully I'll see you in the new year, starting the 11th of January, every Monday, for at least 3 months and then maybe more. Let's see. Let's do it. Okay. See you soon. Bye now. Go on. Go on. Click it. Oh, yes. Okay. All set to go. This is heavy Sanders Waterford paper. Feels like £200, something like that. It's got a little stamp of authenticity there. So, looking at, get the proportions right now, to 7.5, so that 7.5 by 9.5 is about right. So, I'll put a line across there. Zoom in a little. How's that? Let's get this drawn. So, waterline is really low. About there. Trees don't need any details at all. First heavy tree is about there. Well, all trees are a bit heavy, aren't they? They fizzle out. There's one coming across. Another coming across this way. Don't really want to draw anymore. Don't want to be constrained in any way. Now, the birds are the important thing. Let's get this right. Let's do them about 2 inches. No, a bit less than 2 inches, 1.5 inches, something like that. So, one wing, another wing, angled body, curved neck. Looks about right. Short tail. Long legs. Not much of the foot visible, but that should do it. Okay, we have another bird. Here. Wings are on the downbeat, so they will look completely different. That's not so good. I like that. You can erase as long as you do it gently. Don't rough up the paper. Body. The other wing. Legs. In the head. Just a slight curve to the neck. Okay, that looks all right. 5 minutes and masking fluid. Good shake. Oh, smells delicious. Old. It's an old brush. Now it's slightly pigmented, so you can see where you've painted it. Now, as I explained before, this is necessary to isolate the two strikingly white birds from the darkness behind, otherwise I'd have to paint round. And the continuity of the wash would be interrupted by me painting in and out. It'd spoil it. This is one of the few times when I'm prepared to use this stuff. The legs. Right, put your brush in the water immediately and wash it out with soap. Okay, I'll just let that dry for a few minutes. Right, water. Could use a bigger brush for this, but it won't take long. So I can paint straight over the birds. Right, so that's good and wet. And it'll stay wet for quite a while, so I don't have to rush. So up here, this is a violet colour. Wash that out. And down here, I'm mixing red and Naples yellow to get a warm colour to raw sienna. And a bit of burnt sienna to get this right. That looks okay. A hint of the same colour in the water, reflected in the water. So I'm going to darken that. Should have wetted these colours more thoroughly. So this is burnt umber. Some light causing these streaks. Okay. And using this dried up paint, looks about right. It's a greeny colour. Now on this side, I'm going to get dramatically darker. Payne's grey, French ultramarine. Oh. Picked the wrong blue there. Okay. There are some gaps. I wish they were a bit further on board, but never mind. And a bit over here. 12 minutes. Right, looking good. Now as this slowly dries, I want to take advantage of its dampness. Now it's very wet at the moment. As you can see, this is particularly useful in the water at the bottom here. But it is very wet at the moment. Perhaps too wet. I want it to dry more. I'll pause you for about 4 minutes. It's still very wet. This is burnt sienna. Paint's great, very strong. Umber. Burnt umber. Neat. Burnt sienna. Just trying to get this colour right. Always bear in mind the dry paler. All colours. You use two brushes, you got to remember what's colour each is loaded with. So it's still amazingly damp, this paper. It holds a lot of water. the biggest tree. Right. Let's see. Still very wet. Just added a slight violet tinge. I'm fading that away a little bit. Thinking this very thin mix of blue will create a bit of a cauliflower there. When it dries, you'll see what I mean. Now, usually cauliflowers or blooms are to be avoided, but just sometimes they look okay. Right, so I want this to dry now, so about 5 minutes. Almost dry. It's perfect for this sort of work at the moment.
foliage. Let's make it darker. Get this right because I don't want to come back over this. Branches at the back there, all horizontal, just like pine trees do. I'm guessing this will dry a little bit paler than it appears at the moment. Pause you, we're 25 minutes in, so I'll pause you for 5 minutes while I just carry on doing the same. This is a sword brush, fine point, very useful for this sort of work. So the light shining through has brought out the reddish tinge to some of the leaves. Okay, seems to be dry now. Reveal these birds.
perfect. They need a bit of work.
But that's the idea. So I'll just tidy the birds up. Tail looks to have suffered a little bit. They look like they've been dragged through a hedge. Perhaps they have. That's why they want to get away. Dark. Just smooth that in with water. Okay, I keep headbutting the camera, I'm sorry. So I'll back paint around the legs here, just to reduce them a little. Okay, that's not so bad. Tidy up around the tail. There's a hint of an eye. Perhaps I'll leave that. Likewise around this tail, the leg rather. I'm hoping that will dry. I can correct. Got a shadow under the wing.
Okay, 31 minutes.
How does it look?
Looks okay.
I might do a little bit more work around the birds. No, but for this exercise,
turned out not bad. Right. Now,
we're approaching Christmas and I won't be doing any more of these tutorials until the new year, and then this may get taken over by Zoom lessons, which I'll be doing on Mondays and Fridays. So I don't want to push my luck. I think my missus is getting a bit fed up, so let's see what happens. So I know that some of you will be tuning in to the Zoom tutorials. They're good fun. Great. So if you need to know more, you can look on the U3A website or just give me a call, email or telephone. That's all you need to know. Oh, that's my Gmail. So if you want to know what's happening next year, just give me a buzz. But I'll sign off and I'll see you in the new year, and have a good Christmas if at all possible. I think we've got Christmas Day. Grateful for small mercies.
Righty-ho. Bye now.